Hey, all my rock star teachers. I wanted to come on here and tell you about my very, very favorite unit of all time. And it is about chocolate. February is a great time of year to do it. Some teachers do it at the end of the school year for something fun. But I wanted to share some ideas with you that you can use in your classroom. Now, this unit, what I did was I did it for a whole entire month, because I incorporated some books, some web quests, some writing, and then we made chocolate at the end of the month, and I'll share that with you too. So let's start with the books. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory is one of my favorites, and you can also show the movie with this and compare the book to the movie. But what I would do is I would put the students in three different groups, and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory would be my highest group, Chocolate Touch would be the middle group, and Chocolate Fever would be the lower group. And I did little book studies. We had our little novel studies, and I broke them up into groups. Now, how I did this was I don't necessarily have the kids read out loud if they don't want to read out loud, but I do allow those students who want to read together in a small group to do that. And they would separate during our reading time and get together and do their reading. And then for each chapter, I developed some questions to go along with it, and I wanted to make sure that they weren't just regular comprehension questions. I wanted to put in some higher level thinking, some little text analysis, talk about some quotes and stuff like that. And I also gave them some little writing prompts, and that way they were engaged and focused on what they're reading and completely understanding what they're doing. So what did I do during that time? I would walk from group to group and talk to them and see where they're at and kind of pick their brains a little bit and not just always focus on the questions that I provided for them to answer, but kind of dig in a little bit deeper and get their thoughts and just have a real good discussion about the book. And so that's what I would do. I would go from place to place and just talk to them. Then when we were all finished with the book, what I would do is I would have each group come up and talk about the book with the rest of the class. And I did this for several reasons. One, to get them introduced to other books, because sometimes they'd be like, oh my gosh, well, I want to read that one because that sounds really interesting. And other, just to give them some more ideas on how you can incorporate chocolate. So what I would do is have them talk about it, and they would just tell the students about the characters, the setting, the plot, and what all was involved and what they liked about the book. Also, sometimes what I would do is if, say, a group finished early and they were interested in another book, I would allow them to go ahead and get started on reading and not necessarily have all the questions for them, but just to enjoy that book. So that's how I did my little reading groups. And that, you know, took several weeks to get through that if you really took your time with each chapter. Then what I did was we did a little web quest. And these are really easy to make, by the way. Let me put in my little code here. They're really easy to make. So what I did is I made it on PowerPoint and then I saved it as a PDF, because then when you give it to the students or put it on an iPad or a computer in a center, however you want to do it, the students can just click on the links. With this one, however, I did, let me show you, I had it two ways. So in case you had a QR code or in your class or a phone or an iPad that had that, they can just scan the little code there, or they could just use the link and click on it. Whatever works best for your class, or however you want to develop it for your class. But the kids absolutely love this because they were learning about chocolate through a web quest. So you have to incorporate your technology and all that fun stuff. So what the web quest was, is they learned like the history of chocolate, and they learned what the main ingredients was in chocolate and how chocolate is made. And so they would just, here's the questions that they have to answer, and you provide the links for them so that they go directly to that page that has the answers to the questions. But they still have to scroll and do their research and find the answers to those questions. And then they go back and they go to the next slide and the more questions. And what I would do is I would just give them a sheet with those questions on it where they can answer it. So that's really easy to make. All you have to do is find those right links. And I would try to be very careful on the links. And I tried to find ones that didn't have a lot of pop-ups because you never want that to happen. You don't want, you know, something that the kids shouldn't see or whatever. So I tried to find the links that really worked for the students and for what I wanted. So there they are, they're reading books about chocolate, and they are also doing web quests on chocolate where they're learning about how to make chocolate and the history of chocolate that, you know, goes all the way back to the explorers It goes all the way back to the explorers and where they talk about how the explorers bring back the cocoa bean and talk to Queen Elizabeth and that whole history of it coming over and the people in Europe not knowing what it is and not thinking that it is anything and how it develops from there to being that creamy chocolate that we all love. Okay, so that's the web quest. Now I'm gonna go back to the books real quick because I'm just going to talk about each one. And Charlie and the Chocolate Factory is about a little boy who finds a golden ticket and gets to go to a chocolate factory. And I'm telling you, Roald Dahl is just a fabulous author where he brings in so much humor and so much figurative language in the book. So there's really a lot of great detail for teaching and a lot of great opportunities for all the different reading skills used in that book. Then we have the Chocolate Touch, which goes along with the Midas touch. So it's really interesting to see, you know, the chocolate touch and the Midas touch, and you can kind of incorporate that and talk about that kind of genre as well. And then we have Chocolate Fever, and this is when a little boy develops chocolate fever, which is he breaks up out in all these little chocolate spots. And it talks about his adventures and the people that he meets and how that he ends up getting a cure for chocolate fever. So those are all really fun books for the students. They're uplifting, they're humorous, and the kids will absolutely love them. So where do we go from there? Next, what I like to do is do some opinion writing. And I have this article called Is Chocolate Healthy? And the kids get to read about the benefits of chocolate and any kind of chocolate warning. So it gives you the two different types of opinions that you could use, and then they develop their own opinion and write about it. And I'm telling you, they love to go home and share that with their parents and say, I think chocolate is healthy. I think I want some chocolate. So then what I do, of course, you have to have some chocolate for the kids to have a little treat when you're all done with your unit. And you can do little kisses, you know, just like after they finish each little part of the unit. Of course, these ones were for me and the kisses were for the students, but, you know, I hid my little ones aside. And then at the very end, I have a blog post on this one. The very end, we made chocolate bars in the classroom. Oh my gosh, these kids like still talk about it today. Like, you know, I'm going to reveal my age a little bit. But many, many moons ago when I taught fourth grade, and now these little cherubs are 20 years old, and I run into them and I just say, you know, well, what do you remember the most about my class? And they always remember this unit and they talk about making chocolate in my class. And so what we would do, this one was built around Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. And what we did is we developed our own candy bar, because in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Willy Wonka like makes up all these crazy names for his candy and stuff like that. So that's what I wanted the students to do. They made up their own little labels, what they wanted to call their chocolate. Then I had parents volunteer and just send in a bunch of stuff. And we melted the chocolate right in class, so the whole school was smelling like chocolate and everybody wanted to know what we were doing. So after a couple of years of doing this, I finally had to like make extra chocolate bars for, you know, my teacher friends or the principal or or whoever just like kept bugging me for it. But what we would do is we would melt the chocolate in class and it would like smell throughout the school. And then we had all these ingredients like Rice Krispies and marshmallows and M&Ms and gummy bears and whatever the students wanted to bring in. We put them on all these little bowls and it was like a little buffet, and they would get foil and put the chocolate in the foil and go around to each one of those things and decide what they wanted in their chocolate. Then we would wrap it all up, stick it in the freezer, and it would be solid by the end of the day. They could either eat it there or take it home, whatever you decide. But the kids were so excited to open up those chocolate bars and see what they made. And the parents loved it too. They would say that that was such a great experience for them, and it was just really, really fun. So I have a blog post that absolutely talks about all that. If you go to rockinresources.com and just put in the search button chocolate, you will see like how to make the chocolate and, you know, what ingredients I used and how I did it. That is about it for my chocolate experience, but you would love it. Your kids would love it. You know, just build in some fun and some learning along the way, because half the time they didn't even realize that they were learning, and that is a win-win. So I'm off to eat my chocolate. Thanks for listening.